In 1998, Rose Mapendo and her children were imprisoned in a death camp as ethnic violence erupted in the Democratic Republic of Congo. Mapendo's gave birth to twins while in captivity not long after her husband was killed. Mapendo eventually found a new home in Phoenix, where she started Mapendo New Horizons, an organization that helps other refugees like herself. Her story is of courage and forgiveness, and it's featured in the Independent Lens documentary titled Pushing the Elephant, which premieres tonight at 10 o'clock on 8HD. I recently spoke to Rose Mapendo about her life. Rose, thank you so much for joining us tonight on Horizon.
You're welcome.
You have lived just an amazing life. Go ahead and tell us now your background, what happened in your homeland, and how that got you here to Arizona.
My name is Rose Mapendo, and I am a survivor from genocide in 1998 from Democratic Republic of Congo. I was born there. My grandma, we are Tutsi tribe, but our Tutsi tribe, the name they call them Banyamulenge. Banyamulenge tribe is to make a difference with the Tutsi Rwanda and the Tutsi Congolese. I was raised there and I grew up there. My dad was pastor and the big family, you know. But I never have a chance to go to school. It's common for most of the women in my country. They don't go to school. The genocide happened in Rwanda, but I never thought it can be happening to my country because we never live with Hutu and Tutsi. We just live with Congolese. All our life, we speak same language. And when the war began in 1998, this is how our big trouble happened. You know, we was arrested from our government. But when the government, like our president, was announced to kill the Tutsi, I did not come through my mind it wasn't me. He said in television, he said, kill the enemy, Tutsi. Mm-hmm. There was a describe how we look like. But it really didn't not come to my mind, I think, it's me, because it's my country. People, they knew my life. They knew my background. They started with my husband, and I raised the children. With them, I had a successful business. The people come to buy the cows. We have a butcher.
Yeah.
But I was surprised when the government sent the police, four police to my house. I was looking for my husband. And it was a crazy evening.
I was going to say, did your entire family arrested?
We were in that city. We was in Kasai City. We was a five family only. We was arrested, all of us, for 1 second, and they come midnight.
Mm.
Yeah.
And now you wound up in a prison camp, correct? And you gave birth to twin sons in the prison camp?
Yes. Yeah. You know, they took us midnight. All of us, we found out, and they separate us with the men. Sometimes I said, the men, they're so lucky. Because they can kill them easily, or they can separate them with the children.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they keep us for 3 days. They start to want to make a decision how they can kill us when the population knew us. Nothing we have done. And they took our husband, you know, they killed them. It was not only my husband, with the other Banyamulenge tribe. And they left the women thinking they cannot waste a bullet. And they sent us to the military camp. It was in the middle of the office. It's the place we spent 16 months with our children. And imaginable suffering, because they never give us something to sleep on. And they never give us something to cover ourselves. I was 1 month pregnant. I just found out when I was in death camp. It became crazy. It was really totally angry against the God, because I was not agree to be arrested because how you look like, without no questioning. When I saw the children, other women, two women, they was taken away and they were killed. They left their children. That baby began to die in my eyes from starvation. that they have a diarrhea of blood because nothing can stop. Because they gave us, there was a give each family like 2 cups of rice like this. Mm. This I think is big. You know, they cut like this. And like everywhere was the flies. And I was so angry, thinking why God, he allowed me to have a pregnant. If he knew, I would be in that situation. Many times I was thinking to kill by myself. But when I look at my children, my husband absent, I said that it was hard because of the word. They said we will kill your children and boil meat and they give to you. And I knew they can do it. And every night was the end of their life. There was a came, chose some people among us and took them, killed them. That's why it was really making me scary. But because of the pregnancy situation, because my body was like skin came off and the clothes was lice everywhere because we cannot change. And it was a very hard situation. And after I make a decision to forgive the enemy because I thought I was going to die.
That had to be very difficult to do. Now, your sons were born, and tell us how having those children and naming those children changed a lot of things for you.
As I told you, I thought to kill myself for a long time. But when I look at my children, but after I made a decision to forgive the enemy, I feel peace in my heart. And when I made a decision, when I gave birth to twins, that's the situation nobody who can imagine the situation I gave the when I gave birth. It was dark, no light, and it was with 29 children in the same room. You have no other place you can be to hiding your children when you're giving birth. I never cry for pain, but it was normal like other women.
Sure.
And after I gave birth, it was crazy to give, to found something clean to cut the umbilical cord. That was a crazy one. When you see the little baby like mine, see the struggle on the ground, but because I was forgiven already, I didn't even think about the negative. I feel immediately I love my children. I said, God, let me think how I can make it. I can make a change if these people can make a mercy to feel mercy for the children.
Mm-hmm.
That's because I knew Congolese when you name the somebody. Even people in my country, they told me you can never name your child the enemy. One who kill you, one who fighting with you, one who will take your life. And that this is once in history, because a normal, you name the somebody you love. And I believe I love Congolese anyway. And I love them, it's people in my country. And when I named the children, the twins, when the next morning the soldier came asking me a question, they asked, what is the name? Without even hesitate, I said, one is the commander of the city, tell the name, move, and the commander Andre, And they were so shocked for that.
They were shocked that you would name your sons after the enemy.
Yes.
And they were not only shocked, but they did start to show some mercy, didn't they?
Yes.
You wind up in Arizona, and now you've got your own Mapendo New Horizons, I believe it's called.
Yes.
And it's to hear your story, we can't put ourselves there. And especially the idea of forgiveness and reconciliation. What do you tell people? We've heard your story, but what do you tell people about the strength and the power of just forgiving?
My situation is to give a message of hope, because some people, they still live in the same situation. And I say, God, you saved my life for a reason. There is nothing I have done to make you save my life and my children. But my life I have today,
I will use it for you to help other people, because I believe without help one another, life is nothing. And this is just why I started Mapendo New Horizon, just a new vision.
Rose Mapendo's story and her efforts to reunite with one of her children are featured in the independent lens film Pushing the Elephant. It airs tonight at 10 o'clock right here on 8 HD.